Hello and welcome to this lesson brought to you by BitMerge. In this lesson, we'll look at how you can control the way your program is run by adding loops and conditions to different parts of your programs. There's a lot we cover in this video, so practice with some of the code we show, watch the video a few times if needed, and ask questions in the comments section. To begin with, the idea of a loop is something that you're already familiar with. Looping is about decision-making. Think about a driver sitting in a car at a red light. The driver loops through a decision-making process. Check the light. If it's green, drive. Otherwise, wait. The driver goes through this decision-making process several times until the condition green light is true. Equivalently, the driver could wait until the condition red light is false. We'll use this driving example throughout this video to make sense of conditions and loops. The if part of that red light loop is a condition. It is something that can either be true or false. We often want to check the truth value of a condition and then act accordingly. If statements in Python are written using the keyword if followed by a colon. The indented parts of the program under the if condition only happen if the condition is true. As an example, we could say something like if 4 greater than 2, print yes. Running this would print yes because 4 is in fact greater than 2. If statements become more interesting when we use variables as parts of the condition. Let's make a variable called red light and assign it the value true. We can check if there is a red light by writing if red light followed by a colon. Let's print wait if there is a red light. Using the else keyword, we can also tell a program what to do if the condition is false. Here, let's say if red light is true, print wait, else print drive. We can add additional conditions to a control flow using the elif keyword, which stands for else if. We can check one condition, and if it's not true, we can check another. For example, we can check red light, print wait if it's true, or check if the intersection is clear and act accordingly. In this example, if the red light is not on, that is, the green light is on, then we want to check if the intersection is clear before driving. This if, elif, else structure gives us a lot of control over how a program is executed, and shows up in many programming contexts. To mention one more thing before using these conditions for loops, this table shows the comparison operators that can be used. You can see that greater than, less than, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to, and not equal to are all valid with conditions. Note that you need a double equal sign when comparing, because the single equal sign is reserved for assignment, as we've already seen. Loops in Python are just an extension of conditions, but with the difference that a condition is checked not just one time, but multiple times until it's either true or false. We'll look at two loop structures here, while loops and for loops. Both have their advantages, and both are equivalent in terms of how they can be used. A while loop can be understood by the red light example. The while clause introduces a condition, red light, and as long as this condition is true, that is, while this condition is true, the bits of program indented underneath the while clause are executed, over and over again. The moment the condition becomes false, the loop ends and the program moves on to the next bit of code. This can lead to an infinitely looping program if you're not careful. While loops are useful for looping until a particular condition is true. This particular example will loop forever because red light begins as true and is never made false within the loop. For loops are useful for looping a specific number of times. For loops use a special function in Python called range. The range function, when given a number, creates a list of numbers from 0 to 1 minus the number you put in parentheses. For example, range 3 creates the list 0, 1, 2. With these three numbers, we can create a for loop that loops three times. The syntax is for, followed by a variable name, I is very common, which stands for iterator, followed by the word in, and the list of items to loop over. For I in range 3, we'll create a list with three elements, then loop through the indented code one time for each value in the list. Let's just print I in this example. You'll see each time the for loop loops, it prints out the current value of I. Let's say our driver would like to check the red light at most 5 times. We can create a for loop by typing for I in range 5, then indenting the actions that should be taken in each loop. Let's add an if condition. If red light is true, then wait, else drive. This will check the red light 5 times and let us know whether we can drive or whether we should wait. For this example, we actually don't need to check the full 5 times if we already know we can drive. The keyword break in Python tells any kind of loop, while or for, to stop checking and to move past the end of the loop. Now we can see another reason the len function we mentioned in a number of lessons is so incredibly useful. Remember that the len function gives us the number of elements in a list. If we have a list that is constantly changing in size, but we want to be able to print out its elements one by one, we can use a loop to do this. We can combine the len and range functions to make a for loop that loops once for each item in the list. Say we have a list of colors with red, amber, and green. We can use the length of this list, which is 3, as the argument to range, which will cause a for loop to run 3 times with the values 0, 1, and 2. We can then use those values as index numbers and print out the item stored at that position in the list. This is pretty handy and will work no matter the size of the list. One final note before we end this video. Recall that Python dictionaries allow the programmer to decide on both the key and the key's value. This dictionary, for example, uses strings as keys rather than numbers. To loop through this kind of structure, we can also use a for loop, but instead of using range, we can use the .keys function. In this example, .keys creates the list first, second, third, and then uses each value as the I, or the index, when looping, and allows us to access individual items in the dictionary. In the next lesson, we'll extend all of the concepts we've covered so far into the world of functions. Thanks for plugging in. Your thoughts mean a lot to us. Let us know what you liked, what we missed, and what you'd like to see next, and we'll see you back here soon.